to a Trike-tastic Garden Invaders from Nottinghamshire. You all right there, Andy?
Yeah, I'm fine, thanks. Now, of course, we've got the materials, we've got the Garden Invaders, but we'll only have some plants if the garden owners can answer some of this man's tricky gardening questions.
Yes, now talking of garden owners, today's owners are, well, the most interesting couple we've met in a long time. They like their toys. Today we're in Worksop with the Trike fanatics Ray and Glenn Marsden. They were both involved in a road accident 4 years ago, which has slowed them down but hasn't stopped them. They are both keen to have a garden they can enjoy and look after together. And that's something I'm absolutely sure we can help them with. It's a big garden.
It
yeah.
Is. Yeah.
That's a fact.
Do the cats like it?
Yeah.
Yeah, they like sandpit actually.
Plenty of cats.
Do they? They come from miles, 200 miles to use this cat litter tray. It's like going to their favourite beach. Because obviously you've had an accident on the bike, haven't you?
That's
so
right,
it's
yeah.
kind of made gardening really pretty tricky for you.
Well, basically we were travelling home from Mansfield, 50 mile an hour. A learner driver's come over at White Line and smacked into us. What more can you say? It's simple as that.
So you both ended up with you lost your leg as a result of that accident.
I lost my leg and my arm had to be put back together as well. That's pretty much useless, like. I can hang on to trike with it, but...
Yeah, good lad.
That's all I need it for, basically.
Right. I ended up smashing both my legs and pretty much... I don't bend my leg at all. It goes nowhere, like, you know. Right. So limitations for me are really...
And you use a wheelchair as well, don't
yeah,
you?
Yeah, I do, yeah, yeah. So I don't get kneeling down in garden.
No, so that's a challenge for me. I think what we're going to have to do is try and restrict the maintenance to certain areas and also right. so you can get to it easily and work in those places. Yeah. But I think it needs more plants, doesn't it? Nice hedge around the edge, bit
yeah.
of a lawn. But
it'd be nice. It is yeah. a bit sparse, isn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, it is sparse, yeah.
A bit more greenery. What would be your dream out here?
Something to look at other than gravel.
Yeah. I mean, it's an old cottage-style place, but... We've done it up in a more contemporary style.
Right.
We'd like the garden to match.
OK, so who is going to be gardening and who's going to be doing questions then?
I'm doing questions.
Yeah. So I'm gardening.
All right, so you, madam, are coming with me. We're going out the front.
That's right.
All right, after you, lead the way.
And Ray, we have to go into the garden.
You've got to go into the garden. So
right.
we part company at this point, okay. but I will be checking on you later. Okay. So basically what we're going to do is this is the conservatory here and we're going to put solid paving all the way out here through the gravel but we're going to ramp that up here so we're going to get rid of these steps so it's a
right,
nice shallow
yeah.
gradient
yeah.
so that
yes.
it's easy to get Glenn's wheelchair up here and easy for you to walk up here
yeah.
as well.
Sounds good.
And then we're going to put a paved area over here as well which is going to break up the big expanse of gravel and we're also going to put a solid path through to that so you can easily get onto here and then a couple of benches here. I think
yeah.
it's good to have somewhere to sit down
oh,
and
yeah.
relax once you've
definitely,
been
yeah.
around the garden. But most importantly, what we've got to do is get planting into this whole area. So the gravel's good because it keeps the work down, but we need some plants.
Yeah.
You're going to be an invader for the day, thanks Neil. So if you can take that, we'll if you can get that on, then we can start work.
Right.
All right.
Okay.
Now, come across the road to your friend's and neighbour's garden.
That's right, yeah.
All right, and we've filled it with plants that could be yours by the end of the day. OK, your job is just to get as many plants
right.
as you can for the garden. It's quite a big space. All
yeah,
right?
it is, yeah.
They're all in groups, chosen specifically by Andy. Fantastic mixed bag of plants. Right at the end of the programme, though, there is a question for him indoors.
Right.
Right, if he gets it right, gardening question, mind you, gets it right, he gets all that lot. So the huge barbecue, and you like your big barbecues, don't you?
Yeah.
And there's one
big
coming,
family.
And there's one coming up. They normally borrow the barbecue from the rugby club that is the size of a pool table. So you'll be able to use this instead, OK? And the chairs, all the candles.
That's
OK, that's all for later. First off, group one, over here, the architectural plants. First up, Cordyline australis purpurea, or the cabbage tree. It's a palm-like tree with narrow purple to bronze leaves, and it needs moist soil and shade. Formium plats black, known to Maori gardeners as harakiki, flax was woven into food baskets, plates, bags, ropes, fishing lines and nets, mats and bird snares. An incredibly useful plant. And Yucca gloriosa, found in North America. The sap is poisonous and the Native Americans dipped their arrowheads in it. Here's your question for them. Good luck.
Thank you.
The herb oregano is also known by which other name? Is it chervil, common marjoram, or parsley?
I think I'll have to go for common marjoram because I don't really know.
You are guessing though, aren't you?
Yes, I am guessing.
I can tell, but you've guessed correctly.
Oh, wonderful.
Good indeed. Your architectural plants will be whisked into your garden now. Now, if you've ever seen a garden makeover show, and I suspect you have, you'll have seen us using this weed mat, weed suppressing membrane. And this is why we use it. The weeds just root into the surface and you can pull them up like that. That's it. The important thing about this garden is that it has to be able to be useful and easy to look after, particularly for Glenn in the wheelchair. So things have to be easy to access, and this gravel's been no good for that. Outside the door here, I'm going to put a raised bed that can be sat on and easy to access from the wheelchair. And then here we had some gravel and then some steps, which is no good. So instead, we're putting in a very gentle slope. But low maintenance is still an important issue here. So we're going to keep a lot of the gravel, but then just swing paths through it. So it's easy to access all the different areas. We're also going to put a lot of planting here because, let's face it, it's pretty stark at the moment and the whole thing needs livening up. This is going to be a seating area as well, so a nice decent bit of paving, some benches here because it's important to have lots of places to sit in the garden. And then finally over here, because it's such a big area, what we've got is the play equipment and the shed here, which aren't the best views in the world. So we're going to put some screens all the way through here and make this area feel less massive. It was obviously a terrible accident,
yeah.
But like so many bikers I know, you just can't give up the addiction, can you?
No, that's it. That's it. It is definitely an addiction. It is.
So you've gone into trikes now.
Yeah.
Just explain a little bit about those and why you love them so much.
They're just this fun. They're real fun.
In terms of the way they look as well, because Ray's done all the artwork on them, hasn't he?
Yeah, I never knew he had it in him. I didn't, honestly. Honestly, until this accident, I never knew Ray could paint or draw or anything.
And he probably thinks you don't know anything about gardening.
That's true. That is so
and
true.
And you're going to prove him wrong.
I hope so,
all
yeah.
All right. Your second question, the plants up for grabs, first of two groups of perennials. Crocosmia lucifer or Mombrecia. It's a hardy perennial with sword-shaped bright green leaves and tall arching stems of tubular-shaped flowers from late summer to early autumn. It's a stunning plant. Penstemon Garnet is one of the oldest hybrid penstemons in the world. It was bred in 1918 and still one of the best available. Chocolate Cosmos is a native of Mexico. Occasionally it's called Black Cosmos, but it does smell of chocolate, hence the name. Right, beautiful plants. They'll be yours in a second if you get this question right. Here you go, good luck. Ellison's Orange is a variety of which fruit? Now you'll notice that none of the options are actually orange. Is it pear, plum or apple?
Well, being as apples always seem to have silly names, I should go for apple.
Well, like Granny Smith.
Yeah.
It's the correct answer. I love your laugh. You've got a lovely laugh. Makes me very happy inside. They're yours and Nick is on his way to collect them. Nick! Look at that, they're well trained, aren't they? I really wanted to make the seating area in the heart of the garden much more private and also to screen out the overlooking houses and to hide this shed and some of the playground. But instead of putting up a solid fence, I've put up this staggered screen here. And what we've done is create a framework out of timber and then just to concrete the posts into the ground with rapid setting cement so that'll go off really quickly. Now, I quite like rusty metal. Maybe it's a designer thing, I don't know. But this is just reinforcing mesh, and it's very, very cheap. £20 for all four sheets. Much cheaper than traditional trellis, and it'll last just as long. And the point is, once it's covered in plants, it might just as well be anything. But what we have done here is to fill this big, big space with just a few panels and make the whole thing much more private. I'm very pleased with you so far.
Thank Thank you very much.
You're doing very good. Excellent. You're surprising yourself and the entire nation as we speak. Next up for grabs, the second of our two groups of perennials. A Stilby Snowdrift is a hardy deciduous perennial, has fern-shaped leaves and spikes of tiny white flowers in early summer. Delphinium Galahad, named after the Greek word for dolphin because ancient Greeks thought the unfolding flowers looked like dolphins. And finally, a stunning lily. Lilies are found in all countries throughout the Roman Empire. The Roman used it as a cure for corn, so they planted it near their camps. Lovely plants, like the lilies as well.
My favourite flower, white lilies.
Yeah?
Yeah, yeah.
You better get these then.
Yeah, I don't know, yeah.
You better have. This is the important one then. Here's your question then, good luck. What's the name of the process that unites a piece of plant material with another so that the tissues link together? Is it grafting, bonding or splicing?
Grafting, I believe.
It's the correct answer, well done.
Thank you very much, they're my favourite flowers, I love them.
Perfect, they'll be in the garden, you'll be able to look at those all the time when you're enjoying gardening and also from the conservatory. Talking of grafting, however you want to say it, I'm going to check how they're doing in the back garden. I'm going to come back, one more group of plants and also a little project that I want you to do for the garden.
Right.
All right, OK,
right.
Well done. Where is he? Ray,
yeah.
I spotted you through the kitchen window. Most important job of the day, sir.
Hiya, mate. Tee up.
How many times have you made those, then?
About 15. Thirsty lot.
You need to keep them fueled, because they don't stop, do they?
No, they're hard workers, definitely.
And look, favourite plants.
Yeah, beautiful.
Of her indoors.
Oh, she'll love them.
They're excellent. She's got everything so far. So three groups of plants are coming through to the garden. Mm. They have been all morning.
I knew she were good.
You did not.
Well, I didn't really know it.
No, I bet you thought she knew nothing.
That's right, yeah.
The garden itself, you're obviously quite creative, a bit of an artist and stuff.
Well, I like to do a bit, yeah.
You must have had a kind of view of what you wanted the garden to look like.
Yeah,
what
it's absolutely amazing. It's amazing. Can't wait to see it finished.
And there's an invader here I don't recognise.
Who's that?
Would it be Dean?
Dean, oh yeah, son-in-law.
He's married now, surely he doesn't have to impress you anymore.
No, he's got to keep at it, definitely.
Come on, bring the fuel. There, I'll make a couple of paws for you, Lily. Put them somewhere nice. Now, Mr. Andy Sturgeon, are you talking...
Mr. Mark Evans.
Are you talking to plants again, trying to get them grow really quickly?
Go on, no, I'm just teasing up here.
You little teaser, you. But hang on. These plants...
Yeah.
I have not given these away.
Well, they're a designer thing. They're all part and parcel. They're a material, which I'm using in my screens, because although these look a bit naked at the moment, the idea is that it becomes a wall of green. So this isn't what you see. The plants are what you see.
How about everything else? Is it all going all right?
Yeah, coming on. We've got a fair bit of paving to do, and we're going to have some benches to go on here.
Yeah.
But the ramp's coming along nicely. We've got a raised bed coming up over there.
Excellent.
We've got all the plants going on. So,
nice
yeah,
one. Nice one.
Good.
So we're early finished then?
Well, let's not be hasty.
Now, next group up for grabs. I'm going to get an ice cream in a second, by the way, because it's a lovely day. But next up for grabs, your shrubs. First up, Cistus scanbergii, or the sun rose. It's an evergreen, sun-loving shrub. It likes dry conditions and a sheltered position. Fuchsia thalia. It's likely that fuchsias were introduced into Britain in 1788 or 1789, when a plant or plants were received at Kew. Now they've got to be one of the most popular and common shrubs in British gardens. And finally, Olearia. Its flowers are hermaphrodite, which means they have both male and female organs and are pollinated by insects. I have goodies in my hand. In my left hand, seed heads from three plants. All I want to know to get hold of the shrubs is which one of these three seed heads, different types, comes from the plant Honesty.
Well, the middle one, I'm sure, is a poppy. I'm not sure about the ones to the left, whether they're off a laburnum, so I'll say the ones to the right.
So you're going for this?
Yeah. Yeah.
You fairly sure about that?
Yes.
Yes,
honestly.
I beg you. Yes, the right answer.
Oh, thank you.
Very good. Well done. Yes, Honesty, Sweet Pea, Poppy.
Love
fantastic.
That.
You get those. They're going to get whisked into your garden. So the only thing remaining for you will be the little project.
Right. Well,
We've laid this sloping path here and it's ideal for the wheelchair. It's got to be easy to get into the garden. So ideally, it should be a gradient of about 1 in 20. So it's nice and simple to get up here. We've laid it on a full bed mix here of sharp sand and cement, and that's just been haunched on the edge. And haunching just means putting this bank of concrete against the side, and that stops the slabs from slipping from side to side, keeps them nice and solid. And then to point it, we're using a dry mix, it's actually ready mixed, of sand and cement. And basically, you just need to trowel that around, brush it in like this. And for a cheap and quick way to point it, get an ordinary garden hose, cut off about 10 inches like that. And already has a natural bend in it. And you just use that to press it down, because it's not just a question of filling the gaps, you've actually got to compact it, get all the air out. Otherwise, as soon as you get a frost, that will all fall out. And then when the paving comes up against the wall here, to save a bit of time, and also because it looks good, rather than cut all the slabs into this curved wall, I've used these glacial boulders here to bank up against it. And then we've created these planting pockets. And then all you have to do, fill them with soil, pop the plants in, and that will grow and it'll soften all the edges and look pretty good.
I tell you what, this is an amazing trike and the paintwork is unbelievable. Look at that. That is a fuel tank to die for. Salvador Dali inspired and painted by you, sir.
Yeah.
He's a very clever man, I have to say. He's a bit talented, isn't he?
Just a little bit, yeah.
What about you in design work?
Well, I think I inspired that picture.
Did you?
Yeah.
It's quite gruesome, that.
Exactly.
That's what she means.
I had a little hand in designing this.
Did you?
Yeah, just a little one, yeah.
So between the two of you, you should make quite a dynamic design duo then.
You think
probably,
so?
Yeah.
Yeah? Well, we're going to find out now, because together, you're going to do the project, all right? Which is a bit unusual, okay?
Right.
But it's quite a tricky project. Because what we've got is all your old spare parts I can find from bikes and trikes and whatever in your garage. So I'm clearing out your garage as well.
Thank you very much, yes.
That's a pleasure. All those bits are down there. You've got to make something that is a piece of artwork for your garden that says something about you guys, okay?
Mm.
And your interests. Got any ideas?
Well, I've got an idea for a Dali.
Right. What, a portrait?
Yeah. Yeah, I've got some bits and pieces that might work, but... You've
got to have a very good imagination. Portrait of Dali out of a set of handlebars. Now, that has got to be worth waiting for.
I don't know where it'll turn out like that.
We'll find out within a couple of hours, I should say. All right, you crack on. We'll see you later.
Working hard as usual.
Ding, ding, ding,
Mark,
ding,
if you're not busy.
Ning. Well, I am busy, obviously.
Well, come and do this.
It's a lovely toy. You know I like my toys.
I've got something slightly more important that I'd like you to do.
What we need. How can anything be more important than me playing?
Well, let's move on. What I need, we've got some climbing roses. I need a kind of modern metal plant obelisk support thing to grow them up. So I thought you could get these steel rods, weld them all together.
Yeah.
So obviously you need that.
Yeah.
And maybe wind a bit of metal around it.
Yeah.
Get a bit of height in the garden. We can shove it into the ground.
Okay,
all right?
No worries.
Grab those.
Got them.
On you go.
Thank you very much.
Now this is the easiest way to build a raised bed or a wall. It's like children's building blocks, basically just interlocking bits of wood. But this is the clever bit, because these lugs go down and join them all together and this spreads them all out and holds the thing absolutely tight. The green plastic bit goes over the top to protect it. When you bang it in, it's as simple as that. And then the next layer goes on top, dead easy. This is just a coping to finish the whole thing off. I've lined it with this weed mat to stop the soil pouring out through the side, and then you can just fill it up with soil or compost. Now, garden furniture can be really expensive to buy, so we've made some really cheap and simple benches. It's just a new sleeper, which is one of the cheapest ways to buy a decent piece of timber. And then we've made some offcuts on the end, chopped them off, and just screwed them on here. The height of the seat is about 40 centimetres, 16 inches, which is perfect for sitting on like this. And then we've just popped it onto this paving here, but the ends here need treating. So what you're going to do is get a preservative, hopefully this is going to match the colour fairly well, and treat that on the end, because otherwise that's going to rot.
That is absolutely brilliant.
You think so?
I think it's really, really brilliant. What I love is the fact you've kind of mixed two things here, because you started off talking about the portrait, yeah, and that's yeah, kind of Dali's moustache, isn't it, and that's eyes, right, I suppose.
Yeah.
But then the clock. He'd be proud of you, mate. In the amount of time you've had, that is a top job. You pop inside, I'll put it in the garden, I'll come and get you both when
thanks
the
lot,
garden's
yeah,
sorted. I think that's absolutely brilliant. Top job.
The pineapple lily from South Africa is a really exotic little bulb. Has this fantastic purple blotched stem, and then these beautiful flowers with a mad sort of haircut sitting on top. It needs a well-drained soil and plenty of sun, and it's brilliant in pots. The chocolate cosmos not only looks good, but it smells great too. It really does smell like chocolate. It's a little bit tender though, so it needs a good deep mulch in winter, and then it will flower right the way through the summer. Astilbes come in a huge range of colours, from whites to pinks and reds. If you plant them in sun, then they'll need a damp soil. But if you grow them in the shade, then they'll put up with a dry soil. They're tough little things and they'll last for years.
So nearly done, a little bit more grinding just to finish it off. And there we have a garden ornament, something a little bit different to your normal wooden ones. A metal tree up which can grow this lovely rose. It is a bit different, but then I think it's perfectly in tune with the people who live here. They're completely mad about machines and metalwork and all that kind of stuff, and it'll suit them down to the ground.
When you're planning a garden, keep the work down. If you're laying grass, make sure it's higher than the path so you can run the mower straight over the top. This log roll is no good as a lawn edging because you can't get the mower against it and you need to have a strimmer.
Now, air indoors has done exceptionally well.
Oh dear.
It has to be said. So the pressure is on now, Ray.
It is.
All right. And this is not a bit of this show that you've been looking forward to at all, is it?
No, because I don't know what about gardening. But we'll give it a shot.
But give it a shot. Always give it a shot, because it's worth giving it a shot because of what is up for grabs.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
All that
beautiful
lot.
Beautiful, yeah.
Here's your question for the goodies. The barbecue, the chairs, the cushions, the candles, the works.
Right.
Good luck, Ray. If you planted an acorn in Sherwood Forest, just down the road, what tree would grow? A willow, an apple, or an oak?
That'd be an oak.
Am I nice to you or what?
Yeah.
It's the correct answer.
Oh, brilliant.
She's going to be very happy with you.
Yeah. Should have been upset if I hadn't got that right.
Doesn't matter now. It's all going into the garden later on, and you're finished tea making, OK? You can go inside, have a chat to Glenn, but don't tell anything about the garden.
No.
And I'll come and fetch you both when the garden's finished, which shouldn't be too long.
OK.
All right.
Yeah, brilliant.
Top job. What I need you to do, Glenn, is to remind us what your garden looked like first thing this morning.
Very untidy, just a sea of grass and gravel. Nothing much else.
Well, they've been working very hard, everybody, and they've done a bit of work in it. So take a look at it now.
Oh. Wowee. It's unbelievable what's been done.
I don't need onions.
I told you this would happen, didn't I?
You did, and you were right.
Yeah.
This is amazing.
But it really is beautiful, that.
We've got an area now that you can actually get out with the wheelchair and actually use the whole of that area now.
Yes,
that is amazing.
It's fantastic.
So if you just look round past Andy through the conservatory, we've also built you a raised border. Right?
Yeah. So you can do a bit of gardening there.
Yeah.
In your chair.
Brilliant.
Oh, it's amazing.
And then we've put this ramp in as well so you can get out here. And then we've taken down that divide between the gravelly bit and the grass and taken the grass bit so you can get up into all bits of the garden there.
That is amazing.
That is well smart.
But you've got, obviously, your entertaining area
yeah.
up there, which you can both get to really easily, and, of course, the big barbecue. Yet again, Ray has surpassed himself with his artwork. Have you seen his Salvador Dali?
I should have known that one.
That's absolutely brilliant.
Is that good or
yeah,
what?
Yeah, it's very good, that, yeah.
And Mark's obelisk, not forgetting Mark's obelisk
yeah.
there.
Yeah, fantastic, yeah.
Bit of a bike on the top.
Yeah. Yeah. That's a bike theme. And the rose will grow all the way up that. Yeah. It'll go rusty, so it'll go a nice browny colour against yeah. the yellow and green of the rose.
Yeah. I didn't think it was going to be anything like this at all.
It's beyond anything we thought, really. It really is.
It's absolutely brilliant. Yeah.
You guys have had what, by anybody's standards, is a very tough few years, it has to be said. You know, maybe in a little way, very small way. What does it mean to have this now finished in a day that you don't have to worry about it?
It's unbelievable, because we thought we were stuck with this garden that was never going to be anything other than a sparse desert. And now we've got all this.
So does it mean you might spend a little less time on your trikes and a bit more time in your garden?
Oh, I should be around here all the time now.
You'll save on petrol.
Yeah. He'll widen the gateway.
I was going to say, he's going to knock the wall down and drive him
to.
In here now.
Yeah. He wanted to. Yeah. So he can sit and look at
the
garden.
That might be next project.
Very good indeed.
An excellent day. I enjoyed it.
Yeah.
But the best for me has yet to come, because these lovely people said I can borrow the trike.
Well, it's a nice evening, so I'll do more. See you next time.